and welcome to Health Focus, a production of the Ministry of Health and Wellness. I am Fennel Neptune. Today we have with us the health planner in the Ministry of Health and Wellness, Lauren James, who will provide us with some information on the National Health Insurance. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Fennel.
Great. Can you tell us what is the National Health Insurance?
Okay, before I could go into what is the National Health Insurance, I think it's prudent that we give persons a background with respect to where we're coming from with this. I recall back in 97 when the health sector reform was commissioned, that was chaired by Dr. Stephen King. They were looking at gaps in our health system and how ways of remedying it. What they looked at was what one of the gaps identified was that persons who needed care, they were not able to access care as needed because of financial constraints. So this is where our National Health Insurance is coming from, where we're looking at giving persons access to healthcare without them having to pay out of pocket by preparing for health.
Okay, and what is the benefit of the National Health Insurance to the population in this first phase?
Okay, let me just say, I'm sure persons could identify with other persons who have had health crises, for example, cancer. We have seen persons going around with raffle sheets, doing barbecue, because they do not have the money to pay for treatment. What this will attempt to do is have persons be able to access healthcare when they need it without thinking about, hey, do I have money to pay for this? Do I have money to pay for that? So in that way, persons can be more proactive about their health by seeking care when they need it. In the first phase, we are looking at a package of services where we are targeting more or less chronic diseases which have been affecting the country at large. For example, diabetes, hypertension. We have the screening for cancer and other care areas.
Okay. So you're saying that in the first phase of this program, it will cater more to persons with what we say NCDs, which is the non-communicable diseases?
Yes, for now, that I should say that was the initial thinking. But you can well appreciate that this is a process and that we have been in conversation with health insurance. And what they are looking at is looking at more of a holistic manner where persons, we do not want to confine it per se to chronic disease, but more or less on a general level where persons with different health conditions can access care. So we looked at a more general way. The initial thinking was a package, but now given the conversations we have had with health insurance, we are looking more of a general outlook where everybody can see something in there for them. So for example, if I don't suffer from diabetes, hypertension, any of those things, I have something like something, let's say I get breast cancer, I need radiation therapy or whatever, that I can access my health insurance to provide care for me in that area.
Okay, and you mentioned, of course, we're in the first phase,
yes,
of this National Health Insurance. Mm-hmm. How soon do you think that the government will be able to actually roll out this first phase?
We are looking for the end of the year. Right now, we have been working assiduously in the ministry towards achieving that. We've had discussion with the private health insurance providers. We've had stakeholder consultation. We've met with our stakeholders in terms of doctors and nurses to determine the package. We are looking at the different structures which are needed to implement National Health Insurance. So we are looking by the end of the year to implement this.
Okay. So for now, it doesn't just... The first phase, you said, it caters to persons, but later on, I'm guessing, that's where it would be moving to the second phase, right?
Right now, as you know, well, you can appreciate that the fiscal space of the government is very limited. So while the package may not be that wide, going forward into the future, when we see a second phase, it will be more all-encompassing, probably including more services. That's what we speak when we talk about a first and a second phase.
Okay, and what are some of the social issues you would think that affect a person getting proper health services in St. Lucia?
We have persons being poor. We have persons who do not have money to travel to a health center to access the care. We have persons, although they access the healthcare, they not have the money to do the lab works, the diagnostic, to buy the pharmaceuticals. We have persons who have to make sacrifices in terms of family. Do they access healthcare or do they pay for healthcare? And even the situation which people live in, the environment affects their health. So all of those factors impact their ability to access healthcare.
Okay. Well, we are due for a break, so we will definitely continue the discussion after the break. We'll be back in a moment.
Do you know we can limit the spread of the COVID-19 virus? The Ministry of Health is your partner in achieving this solution. Introducing the Amber Wristwatch. The Amber Wristwatch is designed for monitoring daily movements while in quarantine. It provides an accurate location and a precise heart rate. The device is also waterproof and can be worn during all daily functions, like washing the dishes or taking a shower. It's worn like a typical timepiece. The Ministry of Health can now better monitor people in home quarantine and receive alerts of those who do not stay in the confines of their home. A 14-day rental of the Amber wristwatch is just $75. Let us stop the breaches of home quarantine.
Welcome back. We will continue our discussion with Lauren James on the National Health Insurance. Okay, so a lot of St. Lucians and a lot of people have been hearing of the term universal healthcare, which means that, okay, healthcare for all. But can you tell us, is it any different from the National Health Insurance?
Okay, universal healthcare is a term that has been used worldwide by World Health Organization. It really speaks to healthcare for persons, healthcare for everyone, where they don't have to pay out of pocket, where they could access it without suffering financial hardship. I must say, every country has a different method for implementing UHC, and National Health Insurance is basically just the vehicle for implementing UHC. For example, the BVI, they've implemented UHC, and they've done it through their Social Security Board, Social Health Insurance. Some countries have a mix of both private health insurance and social health. So NHI is really the vehicle for achieving universal health coverage for the country.
Okay, and that is done through the National Health Insurance. But we know that work has been done as it relates to the implementation of the National Health Insurance, where we're in the first phase. Can you tell us what work is being done right now with that, in terms of, do you all meet with insurance companies? What exactly is happening?
So what we've done, we've identified a package of care, and we've sent out proposals to private health insurance companies for proposals. We've had to sit with them to provide clarity on our package, and we are now in the process of refining our package to send back to them, and then we are expecting a proposal from those insurance companies identifying what would be the premium, what would be the coverage, and how they would go about, because there are certain requests that we made in there in terms of persons not paying co-payments, or person not paying out of pocket and getting reimbursed by the company. So they will come back to us with a proposal indicating all the areas that we've identified.
Okay. And who does NHI cater to?
NHI caters to everyone. It does not discriminate against sex, male or female, rich or poor, healthy or sick. It caters to everyone. It is the right of everyone to receive health care, and it caters to everyone.
Okay, but how exactly will NHI, how is it expected to work?
Okay, what we envision is where persons would pay a premium every month, or whether it be every year or every month, and they would access healthcare and they would not have to pay out of pocket. Normally, right now, as it stands, for example, I have an insurance package, and I would have to pay for the service out of pocket and then claim from my insurance company. What we are looking for is to move away from that and to have the insurance companies reimburse the providers. So that is the method in which you pay your premium, and then whenever you need the care, you just access and don't pay.
Okay, but you saying that persons would have to pay, but there are some persons who there are people who are unable to afford health insurance. What is in place for those persons?
I'm happy you asked that question, because we do recognize that there are persons who are poor, vulnerable, government is committed to providing healthcare and providing packages to those persons. And we are doing, you may wonder how we are going to do that, because I could be working at Ministry of Health and I tell the government I'm not working and I cannot afford. But we are doing it through a means test where we identify based on your situation, whether you can afford or cannot afford, and then we will provide coverage for those persons.
Okay, so you would be working with other ministries or other organizations?
Yes, right now we are piggybacking on what the Ministry of Equity has been doing, because they do have some means testing for their vulnerable people that they provide support to. So we will be piggybacking on that, and we will be looking at their method. And actually right now we are looking at the recruitment of someone to assist in that regard, someone who has been working with Ministry of Equity on this. So we are looking at that right now to recruit this person in the next few weeks.
Okay, so I'm guessing you would also be getting information from Ministry of Equity on persons who have actually probably on public assistance or something of that sort.
We are working with them, and then we will be using their information as well as going on a drive to identify more persons who may be vulnerable or poor. Also, what we have to recognize too is that we also have what we call the working poor, where probably I am working at Ministry of Health, but because of my commitments, I won't be able to afford health insurance. It will just impoverish me more. So we are also looking at those persons who are what we call the working poor, where we provide coverage for those persons who may not be able to afford coverage.
Wonderful. And one of the things you mentioned, you said the implementation, you're trying to hire somebody in that area. I'm guessing that government doesn't have the funds available for actually providing that service yet. But I'm guessing funds are being provided from the World Bank to help with the implementation. Can you speak on that?
Yeah, I know a lot of people might be saying, we've been hearing of this national health insurance since Jesus was a baby. But what makes it different now is that we have dedicated funding for implementation. In a previous show, we may have reported on the World Bank project where we looked at where we have funding of $25 million. We have approximately $5.5 million dedicated to implementation of health insurance. So that's what makes it different. We actually have the funding now to coordinate all the activities to implement health insurance.
Okay. So right now it's focused more on the implementation. So the funds
yes.
are right now.
I know persons may... people may be wondering, what is the cost? Because we have had consultation with stakeholders and they say we're not interested in that. We more or less want to know what the cost is. But that is a process. We are now working with the insurance companies to determine what it will cost to cover one person or a person and one or a person and their family. So that is in progress, and we should be getting that information sometime in the next few months.
Okay. So I'm guessing as time goes by and the program gets... as the implementation goes, that more information will be provided for the
Yes, public. And that is why we've been having stakeholder consultation with the different people, the unions, the SLMDA, because we not want to come where we just throw everything one time on everybody. We want persons to be involved in the process, what we are doing, what is the model that we are looking at. And that way, when we come with the final product, persons would have been consulted and they would have known what we were doing all along. So in the next few months, we will get the information on financing in terms of what we are going to pay.
Wonderful. Mm-hmm. Well, we have come to the end of our program for today. I want to thank you so much for being part of this program and providing us with information on the National Health Insurance.
Thank you, Fanel.
Thank you. Well, that's how we come to the end of Health Focus. On behalf of the entire production team, I am Fanel Neptune. Thanks for watching. Until next time.